Hi yogis, welcome to MPower 2 with me, Natalia. Sage is gonna be my body today. We are so thankful for you guys tuning in every day, making sure you're getting your yoga, daily yoga practice. For class today, we will need a strap. And if you don't own a strap at home, it's totally fine. You can use a long scarf or a very long towel, anything that you can hook your foot around, and a block. If you don't have a block, you can use a book, anything that is high enough, like even a water bottle, to help you elevate, right, for support today. So if you love Numa like I do, and Sage too, make sure you purchase with our discount code, okay? For every $40 of transaction, you get 15% off with the code MPOWER15. Not only you get the 15% off, but you also will get free shipping. So order $40 or more, and you can get that 15% off with the MPOWER15 code. So yeah, make sure you hydrate at home, especially when you're working out vigorously every day. Make sure you bring back electrolytes to your body, and Numa is really good because it is natural and it's not sweet, like junk, right? There's no junk to it. So, right, you get all the electrolytes without the sugar. And today's class, before we get started, I wanna talk about my theme, my intention. We're gonna work on our fourth chakra, our heart chakra, Anahata. When I talk about the heart, I'm not talking about the cardio muscle, not the cardiac muscle, not the myocardium. I'm talking about the spiritual heart, okay? Which is more in the center, where we feel affection, compassion, and love. And, you know, it's so hard during this pandemic because we don't get a lot of human interaction physically. You know, you don't get to hug your friends and your family. Having that lack of social among your family and your friend, it affects us, and I truly feel it. I am an ambivert person, which means I'm both extrovert and introvert, and my extrovert part truly misses that, you know, that connection, that hanging out and being able to touch someone. And my introvert, like, I get to reflect a lot, be in solitude, and think a lot and read a lot, which great. But what happened with someone like me, it fits in more into my introvert, and I become used to the new norm, and I forget to contact people for a few days at a time because I am reflecting just on myself without other human interaction. And if you are that type of person, right, you have to remind yourself, like what I do to myself, okay, once a day I have to message someone or call someone, checking in with them, because there are people out there who are more extrovert and it's harder for them to deal with the situation, and they need that help, they need that social interaction, and special order people, and that compassion, that love, we need to share that, okay? So, you know, FaceTime someone. I schedule once a week FaceTime and Skype date with my girlfriends, and it's just nice to see everybody and make sure we're cheering on, that you remind your friends and your family out there that they are still on your mind, okay? So still connect with other people without doing it in person. So that's my theme today: your compassion, your love, your affection. So if that is your truth today, if this resonates to you, okay, I want you to practice with me and find the heart chakra for you, the truth of the compassion and love and affection for you. So we're gonna get started in a seated position. You can be cross-legged like Sage, or if you wanna sit the way I am, sitting on my heel, and if that's okay for your knee and you have no any injuries, feel free to do this. And just close your eyes and set your palms, right? One palm on your heart, one palm on the belly. I want you to find both the physical heart, your myocardium, and your spiritual heart. So spread your fingers so widely that you can reach the center of your sternum, the spiritual heart, and the real heart muscle with your fingers. And just feel the rise and the fall of your belly and your sternum and your lungs. It doesn't matter how fast you're breathing right now. I just want you to breathe as naturally. Listen to the sound of the water fountain, how it's very soothing, how it helps you calm your mind, calm the body. And slowly start with your ujjayi breath. Slow inhale into your nose. Start to expand your lungs using your diaphragm and your intercostal muscle, the muscle in between the ribcage and the outside of the lungs. And expand your belly, like your stomach blows up so much like a balloon. And then exhale, seal the lips, slowly deflate the belly and the lungs. Release your breath out of your nose. Powerful, victorious ujjayi breath in. Constrict the back of your throat. Exhale out of your nose. Again, inhale. Create that oceanic sound, the back of your throat as you exhale. Come back to your intention with your breath. Remind yourself that this intention is important to get you through the practice, to remind you why you show up on your mat. Find compassion and love and affection for yourself and others. Blink your eyes open. Good, now take your palms on your shoulders, okay? Elbows bent, elbows to the side. If you're cross-legged, switch your legs. Yeah, so opposite ankles on top. All right, take a deep inhale here. As you exhale, I want you to roll your shoulder forward. Good, just roll it forward and back. Engage your core, keep your spine long, neck is long. Just move it forward, nice. Now, keeping the rotation of the shoulder forward, you're gonna start to add the rounding of your spine. And then back to neutral, and then round. Inhale, neutral. Exhale, round, inch forward. Right, this is what tends to happen for me when I feed into my introvert. I start to round and closing up my heart, and I'm like, okay, no. I gotta remember to spread my heart. I gotta share my love. So now that's what we're gonna do. Come back to neutral. You're gonna roll the shoulders back. Keep your spine neutral for now. Just roll the shoulders back, okay? And now I'm talking from the physical heart to the actual, right, anatomical heart and body. We're going backward so that we can open up your chest, okay? Avoid running through the spine. Also opening up the sternum more. Now we're gonna add the spine. You're gonna arch your spine, right? As you roll your shoulders back, neutral spine, and then arch and roll. Inhale, neutral. Exhale, arch, back, two more. Inhale, exhale, one more. Now we're gonna combine that. Inhale, neutral. Exhale, round and inch forward. And then inhale, open and roll back. Exhale. Just like that. Inhale. Exhale. So it's like a seated cat-cow, right? Yes. Always want to finish on that cow. So you open up your chest. Keep going. And if you are playing music today, you can follow me on Spotify, s.natalia24. And the playlist today under the album Empower, Power Yoga or Vinyasa is Empower to Natalia April. And you can start your play now, the first song, New Endings. Okay, so Empower to Natalia April on Spotify. Five more. Last three. Can you go a little deeper? Last two. One more. Good. Take a neutral spine. Find your tabletop. Shoulders over the wrist, knees underneath the hips. Okay, engage your core. Extend your right leg back slowly. Hips square. I want you to plantar flexion, so point your toes. Then reach your left arm. Good. Thumbs to the sky. Inhale. Exhale slowly, bringing your elbow to the knee. Use your core like you're moving through peanut butter. Slow. Inhale, resist, reach. Good. Nice. Exhale, draw it in. Slow and control. Inhale, extend. Breathe slowly, move slowly. Exhale, draw it in. Inhale, reach it out, hold it. Bend your right knee, grab your right foot with your left palm. Okay, bird dog, pinky side, knife edge of your right foot so you get an extra rotation of the shoulder. And then kick up higher. Use your gluteus maximus, right? The back of your right leg, right? The big glute muscle to kick up higher. Maybe you look up to the sky or towards your left shoulder, lift higher. Engage your core, inhale. A little bit more exhale. Inhale back to your neutral spine, reach and extend. Exhale, set it down, tabletop, nice work. Inhale, extend your left leg back. Use your abdominal walls to extend your left leg. Point your toes. And then reach your right arm forward as you exhale. Your thumb facing the sky. Draw your shoulders to its socket. Deep inhale, lengthen more. Exhale, super slow, draw your elbow to the knee. Use your abdominal wall. Take your time. Inhale, reach, lengthen. Exhale, elbow to the knee. Inhale, reach. And exhale, curl it in. Inhale, reach, extend, fold it. Bend your left knee. Grab your left foot with your right palm. From the knife edge, from the pinky side of your foot. Exhale, rotate your right shoulder. Yes. Meaning rotate your shoulder out and then kick up higher. Yes, nice age. Use your glute, open up your chest, open up your heart. Maybe look up. Whatever feels comfortable, that's too much, you can always look down to help you with your balance. Use your core more to engage through the core to protect your low back and then kick up higher using the glutes. Inhale, back to extension, reach forward. Exhale, set it down, nice work. Good, walk your hands forward, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Chest back, hips high. If it's your first down dog of the day at the class, just take your time to pedal out your leg. Keep grounding to your palms and engage your biceps, squeezing, scooping your arms in towards one another. Engage your deltoids, your shoulders muscle. So you feel the foundation on your palms. Let your shoulders, your horizons, and your serratus anterior, right? Your armpit muscles help you so you're not putting all the weight on your wrist. Maybe you bend one leg a lot, straighten the opposite leg, pressing your heel down. Stretch through your hamstring and Achilles tendon, the back of your leg. And an exhale, switch. Good, and then come to your tippy toes. Look to your palms. Little step to the top of your mat. Take your time. Nice. Feet hip distance apart or wider. Ragdoll. You can grab the opposite elbows. Good, you can interlace the fingers behind your neck or grab the opposite elbow behind your knee crease. Whatever feels good. Sway the body left and right, forward and back, move organically. If you fall, that's good. You're challenging your balance. Find stillness, release your palms to the ground. Use your core, take a deep inhale, halfway lift. Lengthen your spine, hands can be at the shin or on the floor. Wherever you can support yourself, the crown of head reaching forward, neck is long.
folded here. Engage the back of your legs, your hamstring muscle, and your glutes. Inhale. Exhale, bow forward.
Either keep your feet hip distance apart or bring your feet together. You choose. Hip distance apart, it's more comfortable, easier on the low back. Inhale, rise up, mountain pose. Grow tall, reach out. Look up to the sky. Exhale, come see heart center. Samasthiti, standing at attention. Connect your feet. Feel the ground beneath you. Engage the legs muscle. Engage the core, lengthen your spine more. Good, inhale, mountain pose, reach up, grow tall. Hold it here. Keep engaging your bicep. Draw your pinkies in towards one another. Good, relax your shoulders away from the ears, and then posterior tilt on your pelvic, yeah? That slight tilting. So your tailbone pointing down. Inhale, lengthen more. Listen up, exhale, bend your knees, chair plane. Reach your arms back. Squeeze your shoulder blade together, lift your arms higher. Stay 1 inch deeper. Inhale, arms up, chair. As you exhale, vertical twist right. Left arm reaches forward, right arm reaches back. Squeeze the inner thighs. Make sure your knees are not jolting out. Your knees are together. And you sit lower, you twist from your waist up and your shoulders. Inhale, return to center. Exhale, vertical twist left. Sit a little deeper. Keep drawing your right knee slightly back by drawing your right hip back. To keep your knees in line, twist from your waist more. Look back for more challenge. Inhale, come up to mountain pose, rise up. Listen up, as you exhale, interlace the fingers behind your lower back, palms together, pull the shoulder head back, take a deep inhale here. Exhale, back bend, draw your hands away from your low back. Lift your chest up towards the sky. Squeeze your shoulder blades together, keep your wrists together. If that's not accessible, bend the elbows so your wrists can come to touch. Inhale, rise back up, keep the bind. Exhale, soften through the knees, forward fold.
Come all the way down. Soften your knees, your belly to your thighs. Keep drawing your hands away from your low back. Draw your hands towards the top of your mat. Stretch the shoulders. Release your hands to the ground. Inhale, halfway lift, left spine, neck is long. Core is engaged. Exhale, high plank, plant your palms, step your feet back. All right. Feet can be hip distance apart or feet together for more challenge. Shoulders over the wrists, fingers spread wide. Inhale, hinge forward. Exhale, lower halfway, chaturanga. Bend the elbows back, elbows squeeze into the center of the body. Hold it here. For 3, 2, 1, upward facing dog. Inhale. Press down to the top of your feet, straighten your legs, pull the shoulder head back. Thighs of the mat, neck is long. Inhale. Exhale, down dog, here side, use your abdominal wall. Reach, up and up. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Inhale, lift the heels, bend your knees. Exhale, step or hop to the top of your mat. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, mountain pose, reach up, grow tall, breath and movement. Exhale, chair plane, knees bend, arms reach back. Inhale, chair pose, arms reach up. Exhale, vertical twist right, nice H. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, vertical twist left. Inhale, rise up, mountain pose. Exhale, take your bind, opposite thumb on top, the awkward way. Hold your hands back, inhale here. Exhale, back bend. Inhale, neutral spine. Exhale, forward fold, let it go. Soften your knees. Draw your hands away from your low back, fold deeper. Keep the wrists together, pull the shoulder head back. Release your hands to the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Lengthen the spine. Exhale, vinyasa. If you are jumping back, land with the bent elbows, move through chaturanga. Up dog, inhale. Exhale, down dog, hip side. Feel free to skip this all up and just go straight to down dog. Inhale, lift the heels, bend the knees, look ahead. Exhale, step or hop to the top of your mat. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, fold. One last time, inhale, mountain pose, reach up, nice. Exhale, chair plane, knees bend, reach back. Inhale, chair, sit lower, breathe. Exhale, vertical twist right. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, twist left. Inhale, center. Good, come up slowly, this time palms together, bend the elbows, thumb at the nape of your neck, back bend, exhale. Inhale, mountain pose, straighten your arms up. Forward fold, exhale, palms through heart center. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, chaturanga dandasana. Down dog, inhale. Deep exhale. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Bend your right knee, open up your hips. Stack your right bone on top of your left. Gaze underneath the left armpit. Open up the hips more. Good, circle your hip around. You can stay here or you can strain your legs for extra challenge. Reverse, going the opposite direction. Square the hips, inhale. Point your toes to the floor. Heel towards the sky, inhale. Exhale, take your right knee towards your right tricep, hold it. Right knee a little higher. Hold your plank, three-legged plank, inhale. Good, right knee, left elbow, twist across. Inhale, three-legged plank. Exhale, knee through nose. Step your foot through low lunge. Good, come to your spider fingers. Inhale, come to your spider fingers, lift the chest, heart open. So sinking slightly to your hip flexor, right? To your frontal part of the hips. You're still on your toes. You're hovering your left knee off the mat. Inhale. As you exhale, pyramid pose, modify pyramid. Keep your back and lift it. Work on straightening your legs, both legs, front and the back. Deep inhale. Hold deeper exhale. Two more times, breath and movement. Inhale, come forward, chest opens. Exhale, pyramid pose. Fourth foot in asana. One more time. Inhale, go forward. Just lubricating the joint. Exhale, go back. Inhale, back to that low lunge. Hold it. Exhale, left arm down, right arm up. Low lunge twist. Good. Now draw the right hip bone back. Left hip bone forward. Twist from your waist up. Okay. Rotate the shoulder, engage your left glute, left quad. Twist deeper, inhale. Exhale. Now, let your right arm guide you. Spin the back heel down, warrior two, come up. Yes. Open up the hips. Right knee above your right ankle, open up your hips and your shoulder to the side of your mat, to the side of the room. Arms are long. I want you to squeeze your back muscle, your shoulder blades together, engaging your rhomboid major and minor. Sit long into the front leg. Hold it. Inhale. Good. Can you keep engaging the inner thighs and press to the outer edge of your left foot? Sit lower, exhale. Inhale here. Exhale, reach forward. Exhale, extend your side angle. Right elbow to the inside of the right thigh. Left arm reaches up to the sky. Good. Open up your heart, squeeze the shoulder blades. Feel free to stay here or take a half bind. Left arm wraps around. Right hand come underneath for full bind. Now, this is not accessible. You have your towel or your strap. You can swing that towel underneath the right thigh to grab to help you with your bound, okay, with your bind. That's what the towel is for. You can be here. But work on opening up your heart and your chest more, your shoulder. Inhale, exhale. Keep your right knee bent, engage your obliques. Inhale, rise up, use your inner thighs to keep grounded. Reverse your warrior. Lunge deeper to the front leg. Lengthen more to the right side of the body. Deep inhale, listen up for the change. As you exhale, you come up, lift your back heel, low flying lunge, okay? You're going to squeeze the shoulder blades together, neck is long. Right knee bent, let the crown of head reaching forward, lift your arms higher. Nice. Now you're going to take your palms to a lotus shape. Pinkies and thumbs together at your heart center, the center of your sternum. Good. Find this lotus. Find that opening on your heart. Inhale. Good. Listen up. Exhale here. Inhale, ground to your right leg. Lift your left leg off the ground. Find your warrior three. Hip square. Flex your left foot. Lift the left leg higher. Option to stay here. You want more challenge? Keep the lotus shape of your fingers. Extend your arms forward, bicep at the ears. Hold it here. What's important is your alignment. Okay, if that's too much, bring your Lotus back to your heart center. So breathe here, okay? Can you lift the left leg higher? Lower your chest so it's in line with the hips. Yeah, so it's like you're in a capital T position. You're doing great, hold for three. Two, bend your knees, chair pose, feet together. Now, extend your lotus to the sky. Push your knees back. Yes, sit lower. If you have tight shoulders, separate your palms. Or you can keep your lotus at your heart center, yes. Hold here, inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. Exhale, lift the heels, fly your arms back. Ooh, come to your tippy toes. Squeeze your shoulder blades, lift your arms higher. Stay 1 inch deeper. Now, keeping your heels lifted, I want you to slowly reach your arms up. Come to mountain pose with the heels lifted. Take your time, squeeze the ankles. Ooh, I know it's challenging, I know it's hard. Squeeze the inner thighs. Inhale. Now, exhale, come back into the chair. Can you keep your arms reaching up? Bend your knees. Keep the heels lifted. Take your time. Sit lower. Ooh, hold it here. For three. Sit lower, heels higher. Two. One, forward fold. Nice work. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, vinyasa. Five. Nice job. Down dog. Hold your down dog here. Inhale, deeper exhale. Inhale, take your left leg high. All right, bend your left knee, open up your hips. Stack your left hip bone on top of your right. Gaze underneath the right armpit to support your shoulders. Inhale here, exhale, circle your hip around. If you straighten your leg on the other side, do the same. Reverse. Go in the opposite direction. Inhale, slowly close the hips. Square the hips. Heel to the ceiling, toes to the ground. Left leg high, inhale. Exhale, take your left knee to the left tricep. So you're in a plank with your knee touching your left tricep, which is above the elbow. Three-legged plank, inhale, extend the left leg back. Exhale, left knee, right elbow. Twist. Lift the knee higher towards the tricep. Inhale, plank. Exhale, left knee through the nose. Look forward, step your foot through a little lunge, but between your palms. Good, come to your spider fingers. Inhale, lift the chest, okay? Taking this deeper stretch of your lunge, hovering your right knee off the mat. Feel the stretch on your right psoas, which is one of your hip flexor muscle, all right? Just the frontal part of the hip. Inhale. Exhale, pyramid pose, strain your left leg along with the right. Draw your left hip bone back, right hip bone forward. Fold even more. Breathe through the back of your legs here, your hamstring. You can keep your back here lifted, it's a modified version. Inhale, come back to that deep lunge. Exhale, pyramid pose. One more. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, low lunge. Stack your left knee above your left ankle. All right, right palm is your foundation. And take your low lunge twist on your exhale. Left arm up to the sky here. Okay, press so you twist and lift deeper. Draw your left hip bone back. Right hip bone forward. Rotate and twist more. Look up towards your left fingertips, towards the sky. Deep inhale, keep your right quad engaged. Deep exhale. Let your left arm guide you. Inhale, come up, warrior two. Spin the back heel down. Open up your hips. It's a big transition. Your shoulders should be stacked on top of your hip bones. The right hip bone likes to rise up. Lower your right hip bone to level with the left. Good. Nice. Now I want you to extend your arms, engage your arms, your bicep. Squeeze your shoulder blades together, engaging your back muscles. Sit lower into the left knee. Okay, keep pressing to the knife edge of your right foot. Yes, so your arch of your right foot is lifted. Contracting to the inner thighs muscle, your AD adductor. Inhale. Deeper exhale, so strong. Can you sit lower into that left knee? Yes, nice age. Good job, everybody at home. Inhale. Exhale, reach forward, extend it at angle. Left elbow, left thigh, right arm up to the sky.
reach towards the sky more. Create more space. Feel it in your right oblique. You place your left palm on top of your right oblique. You should feel that muscle activating, okay? Stay here or take a half bind. Maybe full bind. Left palm comes underneath the left thigh and grab your right wrist. Feel free to use your towel. That's what they're for. Or your strap. Nice. Work on rotating the shoulder to the sky more. To open up your heart, your chest. Neck is long, chin away from your chest. Deep inhale. Deeper exhale. It's totally normal if one side is harder than the other. We are, you know, uneven. We're not always as strong in both sides or as flexible in both sides. Good. Release the bind. Reverse your warrior. Inhale. Reach up and back. Come up. Stretch and lengthen. Bend the left knee more. Exhale. Low flying lunge. Okay. Lift your back heel. Transition as you reach your arms back. Okay. You're hinging forward from your torso. Your core is activating to keep your body in this 45 degree angle. Okay. Left hip draws back. Right hip forward. You should feel it. A lot of work on your outer glute muscle. Gluteus medius and minimus. The outer side booty. Arms higher and engage your tricep. Nice, inhale. Exhale, take your palms to your chest. Find that lotus shape. Thumbs are connected, pinkies connected, wrists together. Palms open here. Take your time, use your core, launch off warrior three. No momentum. Use the glute to glide up, to elevate you up. Yeah, lower your chest so it's in line with your hip bones. You don't want to lower too much that your hips are higher than your chest. Okay, right leg higher. Square your right hip towards the ground. Rotate your right inner thigh to the sky. Feel free to stay here if you took the next challenge on the other side. Extend your arms forward. Keep the lotus shape. Bicep by the ears. Yeah, if you try and you're like, it's not for me, then pull it back. Breathe. Isometric hold, right? Static hold here. Building strength. Lift the right leg higher. Chest lowers any line with the hips. Hold. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. Bend your knees. Inhale, chair pose. Palms can stay where they are. Or you want more. Extend your arms up to the sky, right? You use your abdominal walls and your back muscle to find the extension. But if your shoulders are tight, just bring your palms back to heart. It's okay. Eventually gain more mobility. Tilt the pelvic floor. Sit lower. Inhale. Exhale, airplane your arms back. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Lift the heels, come to your tippy toes. All right, try it again one more time. Inhale, rise up, mountain pose with the heels lifted. Reach. Focus, balance. Exhale, bend the knees. Reach your arms, staying, reaching your arms forward. Sit lower. Heels higher. Take your time, nice. Inhale here. Exhale, forward fold. Nice job, yogis. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, vinyasa. Good. All right, we're gonna flow breath the movement to our sanghi. So if my breath is too fast, you move at your own pace. Inhale, right leg high. Exhale, right knee, right tricep. Tap and squeeze. Three-legged plank, inhale. Right knee, left elbow, twist. Three-legged plank, inhale. Knee to the nose. Low lunge. Good. Inhale, lift the chest up, open up your heart. Exhale, pyramid pose. Inhale, back to the lunge. Exhale, low lunge twist. Inhale, reach back and open up warrior two. Sit the back heel down. Exhale, extended side angle, bind or no bind. You choose. Inhale, reverse your warrior, reach up and back. Exhale, low flying lunge. Lift your back heel, reach your arms back. Inhale, lotus hands. Exhale, warrior three. Palms stay where they are or extend your arms forward, bicep at the ears. Inhale, chair pose, knees bent, arms up. Exhale, fly your arms back, lift the heels, come to your tippy toes. Good. Inhale, standing up, mountain pose with the heels lifted. Good. Exhale, back into chair. Keep your arms reaching up. Sit lower. Hold it here. Deep inhale. Exhale, open the knees wide. Crow pose. Bakasana. Take your palms down. Elbows bent. Now, yogis, if you're just trying, you can put the block
in front of you and let your head aim for the block. Maybe you rest the block, your head on the block, lift one foot up, both feet up, squeeze. Eventually lift your head off your block. Hold it here, use your tricep. Maybe start to strain your arms more, use your core. Yes, your core is doing all the work here to lift the feet higher. For 3, 2, 1, bend the elbow, shoot it back, chaturanga, not that block. Chaturanga. All right, inhale, left leg up. Use your core to glide your left leg up. Exhale, left knee, left tricep. Inhale, three-legged plank. Exhale, left knee, right to the elbow, squeeze. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knee through nose. Stop it through a little lunge. Come to your spider fingers, inhale, lift the chest, heart opens. Exhale, pyramid, strain your left leg. Inhale, low lunge. Exhale, low lunge twist. Left arm up, right palm down. Inhale, warrior two. Come up, big transition. Spin the back heel down. Exhale, extend the side angle. Good. Take a bind or no bind. Inhale, reverse. Reach up and back. Stretch and lengthen. Exhale, low flying lunge. Lift your back heel, reach your arms back. Inhale, palms to your heart, lotus shape. Exhale, warrior three, glide up. Option two, extend your biceps by the ears, arms reaching forward. Inhale, chair pose, lotus palms. Exhale, fly your arms back, lift the heels up, come to your tippy toes. Inhale, mountain pose, lift the heels, strain your legs. Woo, take your time. Exhale, sit low into your chair. Keep your arms reaching up. Find your stability. Squeeze the ankles together. Good. Inhale here. Exhale, open the knees wide. Crow pose. Palms down. Again, feel free to use your block. Look up. Take your time. Lift your feet up. Chin up. Use your lower abdominal walls to lift. Squeeze. For 3, 4, 2, 1. Shoot it back. Chaturanga. Nice job, Sage. Nice job, everyone at home. Down dog. All right, adding on. One more time flowing, but we're adding things on. Inhale, take your right leg high. Bend the right knee, open up the hips. Stay here, flip your dog, little thing. Snap your right foot to the outside of your mat. Chest up, rotate your right shoulder, your right up to the sky. Take your right palm down. Exhale, right knee, right shoulder, tap and squeeze. Hold it. We tap, pulse, shh, shh. Good, nice stage, good breath. Tap, make sure you're breathing 8, 7, 6, last 5, 4 more. 3, 2, 1, three-legged plank, inhale. Exhale, right knee, left elbow, twist across your body, with pulse, tap, shh. 8, 7, 6, 5, good, 4, keep your arms straight, 3, nice. 2, good adjustment, 1, hold. Falling star rock star. Extend your right leg straight to the side. Left arm up. Chest up. Open up your heart, your pelvic floor, right? Your hips towards the sky. Take your left palm down. Right knee to your chest. Elevator. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Inhale, down. Use your core. Exhale, lift. Use that deepest lower belly to lower and lift. You got this. 8 more. Build that strength. Use your breath. 7, keep your arms straight, so strong. Last 6, keep breathing. Shh. Yes, you can. 5 more. Stay with me. 4, 4. Shh. Last 3. Good. Last 2. Shh. One more. Hold it, yogis. Low lunge. Whew. Spider fingers. Inhale, come forward. Chest up. Whew. Exhale, pyramids. I know you're doing great, Sage. The shake is real. Low lunge. The shake is real. Exhale, low lunge twist. Good. Inhale, come up, warrior two. Nice. Exhale, extend the side angle. All right. Stay here or look forward. Okay, bind or no bind? Bind will be more challenging. Half moon, Ardha Chandrasana, bound half moon. Okay, start to ground to your right foot, float your left leg off the ground. Open up your hips. Now, guys at home, use your block, book, or your water bottle to open up. So the key is shoulder and wrist stack, hips, right? They're stacking, but also your hips in line with your left leg. Look up. Open up your hips so much to the side body. Use your glute muscle to open up the pelvic floor. Now, if you want that challenge, take your time with that bind. Gonna open up. Maybe you fall, come right back up, right? That's all good. Hold it here. Hold your bind or your half moon for three. For two, you're doing great. One, bend your right knee, gently land with control. Ooh, reverse your warrior, inhale. So strong. Exhale, low flying lunge, lift your back heel, roll your trunks back. Right knee bend. Exhale, lotus hand. Good, inhale, warrior three. Strain your arms or keep your arms where they are. Ooh. And exhale, slowly bend your knees. Inhale, chair. Good. Nice. As you exhale, take your palms to your heart. Prayer twist to the right. Left elbow thrust to the right thigh. Draw your left hip bone back. Thumbs to your sternum. Look down to your knees. Make sure your left knee's not jolting up. Keep drawing your left hip bone back. Sit low. Twist deeper. Stay here. Lift the heels. Come to your tippy toes. Hold. Sit lower. Nice stage. Twist more. With control, keep your palms to your heart. Keep your heels lifted. Inhale back to center chair. Exhale, take your time. Strain your legs. Mountain pose. Reach arms up to the sky. Keep your palms to touch. Whew. If you fall or your heels come down, that's okay. Come back up. Inhale here. Exhale, take your time. Bend your knees. Good. Sit low. Keep your arms straight if you can to the best of your ability. Sit lower. Push your hips back. Hold for three. For two. One. Open up the knees wide. Palms down. Crow pose. Ooh, I know. A lot of crow. Take your time. One foot up. Hold. Both feet up. Hold. Squeeze. Three. Two. One. Shoot it back. Chaturanga. Down dog. All right. Deep inhale. I know. Deep exhale. Inhale. Left leg high. Bend the left knee. Open up the hips. Stay here. Flip your dog. Step your foot. To the side of the mat. Wild thing. Shoulder. Stack on the other wrist. And then exhale. You're going to get the shoulder, the chest towards the sky. And then reach your left arm forward to the top of your mat. Take your left arm down slowly. Inhale. And exhale. Left knee. Left tricep. Hold it. We pull. Stop. Shoulders over the wrist. Nice. H. Seven, nice breath, Sage. Six, make sure you guys are breathing at home. Four, three, two, one. Three-legged plank, inhale. Left knee, right elbow, twist across, hold it. We pulse, tap. Tap to the right tricep. Eight, seven, six, twist deeper. Five, hips higher. Four, three, two, one, hold. Strain your left leg across, falling star. Rock star, strain both legs, hips up, chest up. Rotate the chest, the shoulder, reach. Take your right palm down, inhale. Exhale, left knee through the nose, hold it. Elevator, shoulders over the wrist, inhale, lower the left knee. Exhale, pull and lift. Shh. Inhale, down. Squeeze through the lower abdominal wall. Exhale, lift. Arms stay straight, your shoulders remain over your wrist. You're using your lower abdominal wall to lower and lift the knee. Yes, last seven. Six, yes you can, keep breathing. Five more, stay with me. Last four, you're doing great. Three. Two. Last one, hold it, hold it. Low lunge, good job. Woo, come to your spider fingers. Inhale, heart comes forward. Exhale, permit, strain your legs. Inhale, low lunge, left knee above the left ankle. Exhale, low lunge, twist, left arm up. Inhale, warrior two, come up. Good. Exhale, extend a side angle. Bind or no bind, all right. Look forward to your left foot. Use your block. If you have the bind, no block. If you don't have the bind, use the block. Left arm on the block. Start to glide up. Lift your right foot off the ground. Take your time. It's okay to fall. It is hard, especially doing it on a cobblestone.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a whole other challenge, right? If you're like super strong yogis, you're like, ah, I got this. Do it outside in a cobblestone on a mat. See how it goes. Fold it here. Open up the hips more. Stack your joints. Use the glute to open up your hips more. Maybe look up to the sky. Dorsiflex your right foot, right? Flex the foot so your knee is going to its socket and your femur bone, your thigh bone going to the hip socket. Start to bend the left knee, land gently, warrior two. Open up the hips, reverse your warrior, inhale, reach up and back. Exhale, low flying lunge. Lift your back heel, reach your arms back. And slowly inhale, pumps your heart, lotus shift. Exhale, warrior three. Take your time. Option to extend your arms forward, bicep by the ears. Good, bend your knees, inhale, chair pose. Exhale, palms together at your center. Inhale, hinge forward. Exhale, prayer twist to the left. Babi Brita Utkatasana. Look down to your knees. Okay, make sure your knees in line. Draw your right hip bone back if it's not. Sit lower. Keep pushing your tricep. Right tricep against the left thigh. Thumbs to your heart, twist more. Twisting to your ascending colon. Sit lower, rotate. Look up, reach up. Inhale. Twist deeper, exhale. Good, slowly lift the heels, come to your tippy toes. Right, that's your next challenge. That's too much for you today. Don't worry about it, keep your heels down. Good, inhale, return to center, keep the heels lifted. And exhale, strain your legs. Ooh, take your time. Right, that muscle start to fail. It's good, mountain pose. Lift the heels higher. Ooh. Exhale, can you keep your arms reaching out, bend your knees. Chair pose again, lift the heels. Hold it. Heels higher. For a three, two. Ooh, I know shaking is good. I love it. Sage, open the knees wide. Crow pose. Palms down. Elbows bent. Look ahead. Take your time. All right? I'm engaging right here. My armpit muscle, my serratus anterior, drawing them towards one another. And also think about the punching action when we're in a plank. Same. That engage your serratus so then you can feel more stability and you can lift your legs up using your core. Hold it here. Three, two, and one. Shoot it back. Chaturanga. Bend your elbows if you're shooting back. If you're stepping back, you can keep your arms straight. Down dog. Woo. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. How you doing?
Good.
Good. Yes, I hope you're doing good too at home. All right. Take a deep inhale. Take your right leg up to the sky. Nice. Exhale, take your right knee to your right tricep. Tap and squeeze, hold it here. Lift the knee higher. Side plank. Roll to the knife edge of your left foot. Option for tree legs on your right foot. Okay? Or just stack the feet. If you're tree leg, put your right foot in their calf or inner thigh, anywhere above the knee. Even the ankle is fine. Good. Left palm is your foundation. Squeeze your shoulder blades now. Good. Point your right toes towards the fountain, Sage. So point your, that's your left toes, your right outer toes. So the top foot, right? Point it towards the back of your mat. Okay? Now, yogis, stay here. Or you're gonna take a bind with your right arm. Wrap it around to your left hip. I know. Hold here. Three. Two. Keep this bind. Right knee towards your nose. Low lunge. Ooh. I know. Standing split. Left leg off the ground. Use your block here if you need it. Okay. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Exhale, fold more towards your right leg. Breathe into the back of your right leg, your right hamstring. Keep your hips square towards the floor. Breathe here. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, Shiva squat. Left knee thrust to the right calf. Inhale, extend. Exhale, Shiva squat. You want more? Lift your right heel. Inhale, extend. Exhale, take it down. I know. Ooh, I know the calf, right? Your gastrocnemius and soleus muscle are working. Last two. Tap. One more. Lower down, hold it. If your right heel is lifted, yogis at home, bring your right heel back down. Keep the knee, thigh, calf connection. Slowly, take your right palm to your heart. Shift the weight back more so you're on your glute. Okay, your right knee above your right ankle, left palm to your heart. Okay, you're grounding to your right foot, use your core, use your glute muscle, outer glute muscle, gluteus medius and minimus. Palms to your heart center. Lift the left foot higher. Woo! Now slowly come up. One-legged mountain pose.
Holy
cow. Holy cow. Extend your arms up to lotus shape if you can. Breathe here. Level your left foot down with your right. Dorsiflex your left foot. Okay. Take your Natarajasana dancer pose. Bend your left elbow. Left palm facing up. Okay, I'm gonna go sideways so y'all can see me. Sage, you're gonna face forward. Alright? Now you're gonna kick your left foot back. Grab left foot from the inside without twisting your left foot. Left foot with your left palm. Left foot with your left palm. Yes. Without twisting your arms. So I have my elbow facing up. Okay, so if I were holding a lot of change, it will stay up like this. Don't twist your shoulders. Your shoulders are rotating out. Okay, knees together. Keep your hips square. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Find your focus point in front of you, your drishti, something that is not moving. Keep your gaze there. Start to kick, 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 hip square, kick. You're gonna kick using your glute and your hamstring here. So your left foot will kick up so high. If you have a mirror in front of you, it will appear over your above your head. Square your hips towards the ground. If you lose your balance, that's okay, take your time. Keep kicking, dancer. Hips square, don't let your hips open, square to the ground. Lower your left elbow down, straighten your right leg more as you can.
I'm just dancing.
Yeah, you're dancing, girl. Hold it there. Keep going, keep breathing. You got this, right? Like if you see, I'm kicking so much, my left foot appears above my head. Chest up. You can see in my shadow. Hold it there. Keep going. Breathe for three. Straighten your right leg more. Here for two. And one, warrior three. Arms reach forward. That's too much. Palms too hard. Left leg stay lifted. I know. Your right glute is burning. You're doing great. Hip square. You got this. For three. Two. Right knee bend. Land two, warrior two. Open up your hips. Woo! Are you still with me? Yes. Good. All right. Straighten your right leg. Nice little break. Shift your hips back. Trikonasana. Shift your hips back. Create space. Reach forward. Exhale. Triangle. Right palm down, left palm up. Ensure that your right knee pointing the same direction your right toes. Tendency is the knee rotating in, which is gonna hurt your knee joint and your hip. Okay? Point the knee forward. Squeeze your shoulder blades. Open up your chest. Engage your obliques. Breathe here. Some of you will stay here, some of you will take a bath. Hey, you can use the strap here in your triangle with the bar. Yeah, don't worry about it today if you don't have the bar. You can keep retaking this class and see your progress. Okay? Hold. Squeeze the inner thigh, strain your arms, reach back and up. Reverse your triangle. Exhale, windmill the hands down. Good. Take your high plank. Option to keep your right foot lifted. Exhale, vinyasa. Down dog. Whew, you got this. Inhale. Deep exhale. Almost there. Inhale. Take your left leg high. Exhale, left knee, left shoulder. Step and squeeze. Hold it. Okay, lift the knee higher. Right palm is your foundation. Side plank, Vastisthasana. Roll the knife edge of your right foot. Right shoulder over your right wrist. Feel free, right, to stack your feet, stagger for more stability. You want the challenge today? Take your your tree variation. Left knee pointing to the ceiling or to the sky. Left foot to the inside of your right thigh or calf. Avoid the knee joint. Okay, squeeze the shoulder blades. Your knee likes to go forward and back, now side to side. Engage your obliques more. Stay here, take a bow. Wrap it around. Breathe. Hold. Build strength. Stay on the bow. Take your left knee to your chest. Low lunge. Whew. It was not easy. Well, you got this. Standing split. Float your right leg off the ground. Keep your hips square. Whew, you got this, yogis. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold even more. Keep your hips square. Work on lengthen your hamstring. Okay, gaining more mobility. Especially if you're tight, just use the block, anything accessible. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, Jifa squat. Take your right knee, dress at the left calf. Lift the chest. Inhale, standing split. Exhale, Jiva squat. Option to lift your left heel off the mat to engage your calf more. Inhale, extend.
Good.
Yeah, earthquake is good. Exhale, come down. Two more. Inhale, mini earthquake, right? Your calf, your gastrocnemius, glute, your soleus muscle are working. Last one, inhale. Nice breath. Exhale, down, hold it. Okay, bring your left heel down. Keep that squat. Left palm to your sternum. Right palm to your sternum. Palms together. Okay, shift your weight back so your knee and ankle are stacked. You should feel in your outer glute muscle, right? Abs engage. Take your time. With control, come up. Ooh, one-legged mountain pose. Start to strain your left leg. Lift the chest up. Right knee floats up. Keep that. Find your lotus arm. Extend your arms up. Level your right hip bone. Find strength. You're a gorgeous warrior, strong warrior. Come back to that intention. Take your Natarajasana, dancer pose. Bend your right elbow, palm face up. Okay, I'm gonna face sideways. Keep your palms facing up, keep your shoulder rotating up. Bend your right knee, gap your right foot with your right palm from the inside. Okay, the inner edge of your right foot. Find your focus point again, yogis, your drishti in front of you that is not moving. Inhale, lift the chest up. Exhale, start to kick. Don't hinge forward yet. Just work on the kick. Hip square kick. Hip square kick. Use the glute. Okay, gluteus maximus muscle. Then square. Lift the chest. You can lower your chest slightly, but lift up higher. You want to create that back bend. Hip square. Kick up higher. Chest up higher. Kick. Hip square. Hold it. Breathe here. Okay, take your time if you fall. Do it two more times, one more time. You get better, you get deeper, you get stronger every time. Can you kick a little higher? I'd rather have you try and fail than never trying at all. So you know your limit. Keep going. Hold it here for five. Kick up higher, four, so your foot appears behind your head. Three, two, warrior three, and one. Ooh, don't let your right foot touch the ground. Can you do that? Yes, 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 reach arms forward, right foot floating. Maybe palms stay at your heart. Hip square. Okay, no ego, do what you can. Do what you need. Bend your left knee, warrior two. You never would think in a million years, warrior two is a break right now. Ooh, strain your left knee. Shift your hips back. Not the shoulder, but the hips, yeah. Good, nice H, good job. Reach your arms forward, your shoulders forward, good job. Left palm down, right arm up. Trikonasana, triangle pose. Squeeze your shoulder blades, look up. Hold it. Neck is long. Engage your right obliques. Squeeze the adductors of your inner thighs. Feel free to stay here or take your bind. Right arm wraps around. Left arm comes underneath the left thigh. Grabbing your right wrist. Right? You're still keeping the integrity of the posture. The bind is extra for that deeper heart opening. Release the bind, reverse your triangle, inhale, reach up and back. Chest opens up. Exhale, windmills the hands down, low lunge. Inhale, three-legged plank, send your left leg back. Keep your left foot lifted for more challenge. Exhale, vinyasa. Ekapada. Down dog.
deep inhale. Deep exhale. We're just laughing because yoga is fun, you know, and making this video, we do things that,
we're just building core right now.
Exactly.
Inhale, lift the hands, lift the heel, step or hop to the top of your mat. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, fold. Grab your strap. Rise up all the way to your mountain pose. All right. So, grab your strap, your towel, your scarf, whatever you have at home. I know, look how white my strap is. I just wash it. I wash everything. I'm going crazy.
Same.
I change my sheet like every other day. Usually, I'm lucky if I change my sheets once a week. Now it's like every other day, new sheets. Better save them, sorry.
So clean.
Yeah, it's good, right?
Beautiful.
Gorgeous. Can we keep this up, right? Once we're all back to normal? Let's hope so. Okay, make a little loop. If you have a scarf and it's long enough, you can do the same thing, tie it up and create up a little loop. If not, just fold your scarf or your towel like this and just put your foot around, okay? It works. Okay, let's start with the left leg as your foundation. Put the right foot on the strap. Right? Now, ground to the left leg. I'm gonna turn sideways. Take your time. You're going to reach your arms back. Okay, it's like you're climbing a rope instead of up, down. So decline the rope. So don't let your arms extended up here. Keep your palms behind your head like a tricep extension, but you're keeping the elbows bent. Engage your core, start to kick up. Climb, climb, kick, 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 right? Eventually, you kick so much, you can feel your toes, okay? You kick so much, lift. You feel your foot. And just go wherever you can, just hold it. Eventually, you grab your whole foot. Ooh, maybe not today. And you take your full dancer pose. It's like an O shape, okay? Let's go. Let's try it. Try a few times, once or twice, okay? Maybe three times, because the first time is always the hardest. And then the body get used to it, get more mobile, and you can go a little deeper. Good, nice, keep going, Sage. Keep breathing, okay? Keep kicking, yes you can. So you guys can keep doing this longer than I'm asking you, because you have the flexibility to pause me and stay here, especially after we're moving on. And then maybe release. And then try your second side. Sometimes one side is better than the other. Okay? Yeah. And then usually I can grab my foot easily, but some days it's tight, you know, haven't done maybe yoga in a while, been sleeping, eating potato chips, you know, so it's a lot harder after a week of hiatus. But we're here together. So now, let's do it. Take your time. I'm gonna go this way. Let's see. So your right leg's your foundation. Keep climbing down to your strap, your rope. Left leg higher, keep kicking. Keep breathing. All right, if you have a mirror, it's nice, because you can see how far you are. Yeah, this side I can grab my foot easily. Yeah, and just hold on to your foot if you have it, guys, and kick more. And pull your elbows back more, your chest up more, so your foot becomes like a pulley to open up your chest more, to open up your heart, your anahata, for a chakra. O shape, breathe. One more try, maybe. Or you're like, I'm over this. Totally fine with me, too.
It's a good stretch on the arms.
Yeah, good stretch on your tricep, right? Because you're getting that pull back, and that's why you use a strap. And if you have the foot, your foot helps you to stretch the sternum, the armpit muscle, and your tricep, your chest, right? It's like somebody like doing a Thai massage on you, kicking your back and pulling you back, okay? So that's why you get your back stronger and you open up your heart more. And that's why this theme today, it's because we do close up physically and emotionally, okay? Being on a computer, laptop, or introverting more in. I'm opening up you, right? Physically and hopefully emotionally. All right, so do that, because we tend to do more flexion than extension. All right, whew. Take a deep inhale, reach arms out, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold deeper. Now bring your feet hip distance apart. And I want you to fold even more. Hook your big toes with your peace finger. Okay. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold, bend your elbows, fold more around your spine, do a flexion, bend your knees a lot more. We did a deep, deep, deep extension back bend. Release your hands, inhale, half lift. And exhale, have a seat. Good, let's take Janu Shirshasana. Extend your left leg, take your right foot to the inside of your left inner thigh, okay? Right knee pointing to the side. Take a deep inhale, reach arms up, lengthen your spine. Now exhale, come forward, round your back. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold, surrender. Get a little bit more flexion going on in here. You can always use your strap here, backstage, do this. Yeah, so you get nice like hamstring stretch. You guys at home too, you can use your towel or your scarf to get this hook on the foot with your strap so you can get the hamstring lengthened, but also you can fold deeper. Feel that nice stretch on the back of your leg. Inhale, come up. Feel free to stay here longer. Exhale, we're gonna switch. Right leg extend, left foot to the inside the right thigh, okay? Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, hinge forward. Yes, now you can hook your foot with the strap, fold it around. All right, so then you can get that nice lengthening on your right hamstring and your spine. Exhale, release your arms by your side. Extend your legs forward. Let's make your way down to your mat. Lower down slowly to the ground. Left foot down. Left knee bend, right ankle, left quad. Feel free, if you wanted to take pigeon, right, regular pigeon, you come up and do regular pigeon. If not, you're gonna be doing reclining pigeon here, left foot off the ground. Grab the needle, interlace your fingers here behind your hamstring. Push your right forearm even more towards your right thigh to open up your right outer hip. Okay, the right outer hip, stretching your piriformis. Feel free to stay here, strain your left leg to the ceiling. In some view, you can do cradle of baby, left leg lowers down, right foot to the left elbow, right knee to the inside of the right elbow. And close your eyes. Enjoy this stretch. Remain here for as long as you need. If you're moving on, find an eagle wrap so your right knee crosses over the left leg. Arms out to a T, cactus. Good. And then split your hips to the right by setting your left foot down and then drop both knees to the left. Keep your right shoulder down. You can keep switching your hips to the right. Twist. Alright, we did so much extension. It's good to not only do flexion but also twist to re-neutralize the spine. Stay here for another 8 breaths, or if you're moving on, come back into center. Take a uncross the leg, figure four on the left side, left ankle, right quad. Thread the needle, interlace the fingers on the belly of your right hamstring, the back of your right thigh. Use your left tricep forearms to push your left leg away from you. Right, you should feel it right here. This is your piriformis, the outer hip muscle. Flex both feet to protect your knees. Extend the right leg for a little bit more in the hamstring. Maybe cradle the baby, lower your right leg all the way down, but then you get your left foot to the right elbow crease, and then left knee to the left elbow crease. Okay, interlace the fingers. If your head is lifted off the ground to do this, just do the regular figure four because you need to keep your shoulders and the head relaxed and feel the deeper sensation on this piriformis stretch. Keep drawing your left shin up towards your nose, just in line with your left knee. When you're ready, find your eagle wrap, left thigh on top of your right thigh. Set your right foot down, scoot your hips to the left, then drop both knees to the right. Okay, keep scooching your hips left. Keep your left shoulder down. If you get a little crack, that's nice, right? Especially a lot of chiropractor are not practicing now and giving you adjustments. So you gotta self-adjust yourself, or self-adjustment. Good, enjoy this twist. Realigning the spine, releasing tension on the glute, core, and spine. If you're able to practice outside today, yogis, practice outside. It's such a beautiful day. The air smells so fresh, right? Because less people are driving, no more, less, very little people flying. That the quality of air is so much better than ever now in Los Angeles. Inhale, return to center. Uncross the legs, take your blissful baby, Ananda Balasana. Capture the inner or the outside of your feet, right? Whatever feels comfortable for you. Keep tailbone the mat. So then you're decompressing the spine. You're not rounding. Ankles and knees are stacked. Rock your baby side to side. Option to hook your big toes with your fist fingers. Strain one leg out, one leg out, and the other. Maybe both legs out, and then you can touch your friend. Rock it side to side. Right? Do what you feel good right now. Slowly, when you're ready, come into a ball. Have your knees into your chest. Lift your shoulder blades off the mat. Draw your forehead towards your knees. Grab the opposite elbows around the shin. Flex your feet. Squeeze yourself tightly. Take a deep inhale here. And exhale, release final shavasana. Beautiful, guys. Completely let go. Melt your body to the ground, toes fall out, arms by your side, palms face out, jaw relax, eyes are closed, melt your body completely to the ground. Please stay here for a few more minutes, giving yourself this time to recover, but also self-love. And reflect back on your intention, our heart chakra, our anahata, giving compassion and love and affection to ourselves and others surrounding us. Thank you so much for joining me another day, another practice of yoga, yogis. It's been a pleasure guiding you through this journey. Namaste.